Yupo and alcohol inks continue to be a really popular product combination. Everybody likes all of the ways the inks can be used and manipulated on the surface of the Yupo. Debuting today is a new Joggles product that I'm really excited about that takes this pairing and pushes it right outside of the creative box, Yupo Art Parts. Shapes cut from Yupo that you can use all of your favorite techniques on. Yupo isn't traditional paper made from tree pulp, it's a synthetic that's manufactured from plastic. It's non-absorbent, bright white, and it resists buckling unless you add heat. We've stocked it for a long time, and people who work with alcohol inks love it because you can see the results you get here. It's just wondrous on Yupo. It's available in pads of various sizes. You can get it in rolls or sheets. You can cut it with scissors or a die. If you have the die that you want or you're willing to do the work to cut the shape out, then you can have it. But if you don't have the die or you didn't want to spend the time cutting, then I have good news for you. I'm really excited to introduce our newest Joggles product, Yupo Art Parts. And we're starting simple. We have artist trading coins. These are the 2.5-inch coins and standard ATCs trading cards that are 2.5 by 3.5. So you can see that, you can see how fabulous the Yupo looks on it, and the alcohol ink looks on it, and then of course, don't miss those foils, we'll talk about those in the next segment. So if you've worked with alcohol ink on Yupo, you're probably aware that it's important to keep the surface as clean as possible. That's one of the things that I preach all of the time, but there is a certain amount of handling that has to happen when we transform large sheets of Yupo into smaller parts that are in packages. So we're wearing gloves, but you need to be aware that it's probably not going to be as pristine as if you just pulled a sheet from a pad. That's just the nature of the manufacturing process. Having said that, I did all of this. I didn't have any difficulty at all. It works really, really well. So I'm going to start with a simple technique. Let me slide these out of the way. In fact, it's going to be this one that kind of is a marbling or an agate technique. It doesn't get much simpler than this. So I'm working on a palette pad. The reason that I do this is because, see this stain right here? This is a little mar in the surface of my nonstick craft sheet that covers my workbench. And anything that does this, the alcohol ink will stain. So to avoid that, even though it cleans up, it's not pretty to look at, and it gets distracting, so I try to keep it clean. So here are some ATCs, artist trading cards, and some artist trading coins. And I'm going to use three colors. This is the mini ink blending tool with one of the felts on it. I'm going to use Cool Perry, just squeeze some out there, and Amethyst and Lettuce. It's a wonderful color combination. The nice thing about doing this is that these three colors would ordinarily make a muddy mess that nobody would be happy with, but alcohol inks are really, really forgiving. I'm just going to stamp off some of this excess. They're really, really forgiving, and so you can get some wonderful effects. You get these colors that are completely opposite one another on the color wheel, so you get that pop that goes along with complementary colors, but you don't get mud, which is simply amazing. So you can see what happens when there's a lot of ink and it starts to evaporate. All of the shapes, all of the little areas that you get that are caused by applying this start to blend and smooth out. The less ink there is on here, and I'm just going to knock some more of it off, and I'm going to tap it really lightly, and you can blow on it, but the less ink there is on here, the evaporation happens a little bit differently, and you'll see you start to maintain shapes. And that is a property of alcohol ink on Yupo that is true no matter how you're applying it or what you're doing, and you'll see later on, as I show you a couple other techniques, that this property will hold true across all of those techniques. And as you play, you'll discover this. Now, obviously, there are a bajillion ways to work with alcohol ink on Yupo. In the next segment, I'm gonna show you a couple really simple ones, and I am gonna bring in some foils because if you can add some glimmer, there just is nothing not to like about that. You can see that there's some here, there's a little bit on here. I used some copper. So you can really kick this up quite a few notches when you add things like foils. Using alcohol ink to create dots and incredible patterns on Yupo is one of the first videos that I filmed, and it's a technique that I tend to come back to. So I'm back with amethyst, but this time I have salmon and flamingo, and I've got lettuce off to the side here in case I decide I want to use it. So all I'm going to do is start by putting some drops on here. Big drops, little drops, you can spatter things, there's lots of different ways to get some really effective things going on. And you'll also see me come in with this coffee stirrer. I like to manipulate the color. I like the way that it looks like that. So let's bring in some of the amethyst. Now, I'm not making great art here. All I want to do is show you how this works. So you can see that this is the challenge, the fun challenge with Yupo. Sometimes, and I'm not talking about handling here, that can play into it, but even when you don't handle the Yupo, you might get something like this, you might get ruffles like this, or you might get something that is more amoeba-like than circular. And so you kind of never know. It's wildly unpredictable, which can be really part of the fun part about working with alcohol ink on Yupo. So I can start pushing these in, and again, normally green and pink and purple would make a horrific mess. So let's bring the coffee stirrer in, and I'm going to start moving this around. Now, alcohol ink does have a tendency to stain Yupo, because it's said that you can wipe things off, but you'll find that those stains stay. Now, just like the last time, because this is still wet, you can see that the marks that I'm making have a tendency to soften, and I'm going to blow on that to hasten the evaporation. But as you start to play a little bit more, and you continue to work at that color that's on there, the marks will remain because enough of the solvent base has evaporated off to allow them to kind of stay. So I like to do this. I like to play around with a coffee stirrer like this. I find it gives me really good results. Like, I kind of like that. And I can always come back and I can add some more drops to that. So let's just come in here for a second and see what we can do, because this is still a little bit damp. See how you get that really cool zigzaggy pattern? I like that. I think that that's really interesting. Now, normally I would not be working on three things at once like this, but you know, it's fun to play around and to do some interesting and different things. So I started off with something that looked kind of brown, but as it spread out, you can see the flamingo and the purple kind of doing their thing, and that what looks like mud goes away and you get some interesting things underneath. Now, I can come back and I can add some dots to this. So I'm going to come back with these colors and I'm just going to put some dots on here, and you'll watch. Here's the bloom. This is the magic that happens. It's so much fun, and it's really exciting to see this because you never know what you're going to get. You can also do things like, I'm just going to take the salmon and I'm just going to spatter it, so you can kind of get little tiny dots like that. So you get all different kinds of patterns depending on how you add the ink. And you can put some alcohol in a mister bottle. What I like to do, and I'm going to pull these out of the way for 1 second, there's some drying going on that I'm going to take advantage of in a minute. I like to spray from really high, just mist a little bit. Now that was more than what I wanted, but because I didn't flood it, because I didn't flood the surface with the alcohol, it will actually hold those shapes pretty well. And then if I decide I want to come back and add some dots over the top of that, I can certainly do it. All right, so enough has been going on over here. I'm going to touch. This is still too wet, so let's try this and see what happens. The time to do this might have already gone by. If you put foil on here, when alcohol ink is drying, it goes through this stage where it gets just the tiniest bit tacky. And you can see where that happened. As I hold this up, you can just maybe see there's a little bit in here. I waited a little bit too long, but you can see it here. You get the foiling that gets grabbed. So it goes from being very wet to this tacky state, which allows you to do fun things like foil on it. So let's see where we are here. This is still kind of wet, but I'm going to try foiling it anyway. Now, when you work with foil, the thing that I always remind people is make the pretty side up toward you. As long as you have that side facing you, when you foil, you will see the pattern of the foil when it adheres to whatever is sticky enough to make it behave like foil. And off this comes, and how awesome is that? Look at that foil in there. Isn't that amazing? So I'm going to come back and try again and see if there are any other spots that I can pick up. Now, this is not done just because I foiled it. I can come back and I can put some more drops. So let's say, for example, I want to come in here with the salmon and put a drop in the middle here, and you can watch it bloom and push the color out. And I'm going to put a couple of drops there. And now what I'm going to do is let this ridge here dry just enough, and then I'll come back and I'll foil it too. I'm probably going to use the pink because everything else that I've got out here, probably not a good choice. So it's just a matter of, and you'll play with this, and the first time you'll put it on and it'll be too wet, it won't work the way you had in mind, but you just have to remember that you'll play a little bit and you'll touch and you'll see whether or not this is ready. So let's give this a whirl and see what happens. And nope, I went too soon, and by doing it too soon, it might be that there's simply, wow, there's simply not enough left on there. So let's try something else. Let's come back with the flamingo and put a dot in here, and we'll put a dot in here, and we'll wait and see what happens. So we're gonna find that in-between state. I mean, it certainly works because you can see it. So I've got a little bit of a thicker ridge going on here that I might be able to capitalize on. It's just a question of blowing on it and letting it do its thing. Now what you'll see, I'm waiting here, what you'll see is alcohol ink on the back. That's obviously a place where you put it on that it was too wet. So again, this is a trial and error process. You'll learn how it works as you go along. Let's see if this is ready. Nope, I think that's still a little bit too damp. So we'll just try to hasten this process to get it to that sticky state. I think we're almost ready. So let's try putting that on there and seeing what happens. And I did get a little bit. Oh, in fact, I got some right here. See how you can just see the foiling around there? So here's the thing. These are brand new. There will be more shapes coming, I can promise you that. But for now, let's get this out of the way because it's a mess. We're going to start with artist trading coins and artist trading cards. The good news, alcohol ink on sale at 25% off. The Gina K foils on sale, also I think it's 25% off, and the ICraft Deco foils are also on sale. So all the stuff that you need to do this is not only available, but it's on sale, so you can splurge a little bit and not break the bank.